Pi is the ratio between the circumference of a circle and its diameter, and we have many methods to approximate its value. The one we will see today is by using a Monte Carlo algorithm. A Monte Carlo algorithm is a randomized algorithm whose output may be incorrect with a certain margin of error. How can we make one to approximate pi? Let's start. Let's take a square of side L, with a circle inside it of radius r, which is in reality l divided by 2. What about the area of these two shapes? The area of a square is its side length squared, l squared. And the area of a circle is pi times r squared. The radius here is l divided by 2, so the area of the circle is pi times l divided by 2 squared. Let's name the ratio between these two areas k. K is the area of the circle divided by the area of the square. Let's simplify the equation. L divided by 2 squared is L squared divided by 4. We multiply both sides by L squared. We multiply both sides by 4. We remove L squared from both sides. And we get this equation. Pi is equal to 4 times K, the ratio. It means that if we can get the value of K, we just need to multiply it by 4 to get the value of pi, what we're searching for since the beginning. But the big question is, how to get the value of k? And this is where the randomized part comes in. We can just generate a bunch of points in our square. All points are inside the square, so they all constitute the area of the square, but only those inside the circle that constitute the area of the circle. So what we can do to calculate the ratio is to divide the number of points inside the circle by the total number of points. And that's the idea of our algorithm. Generate a bunch of points, count how many ones are inside the circle, calculate k, the ratio, and multiply it by 4 to get pi. Obviously, points are not occupying the whole area. We won't get the exact value of k. This is why we'll just get an approximation of pi. But, in general, the more points we generate, the more our approximation will be close to the real value of pi. We'll see it in the experimentation part. Before, let's implement this algorithm. We will be using Python with a NumPy module. We assume that our circle is centered at 0, 0, and that its radius is 1. So, a side of the square has a length of 2, and it's between minus 1 and 1 in both x and y axis. This is why, to generate a point in the square, we just generate two random numbers between minus 1 and 1. And we want to generate n points, so we generate a matrix of random numbers between minus 1 and 1 of n rows and 2 columns. Next step, count how many of them are inside the circle. In general, to know if a point xy is inside a circle of radius r, centered at xcyc, we just check if square root of x minus xc squared plus y minus yc squared is smaller or equal than r. In our case, xc and yc are 0, and r is 1, so we just check if square root of x squared plus y squared is smaller than or equal to 1. And because a positive number whose square root is smaller than or equal to 1 is itself smaller than or equal to 1, we can remove the square root. We write this for our array of points. We get a Boolean array with true for points that satisfy the condition and false for others. To count the number of true values, we just use sum. It will treat true values as 1 and false values as 0. Last step, we calculate k, the number of points inside the circle divided by n, the total number of points, and we multiply it by 4. We get an approximation of pi that we return. That's it. I could use pure Python to implement this by using a loop, but I prefer to use NumPy because it's faster for this kind of tasks. Let's now move to the experimentation part. By trying this algorithm with more and more important values of n, we can notice that the output is getting closer and closer to the real value of pi. Look how the difference is decreasing. At the end, we got a difference of less than 0.0003. We can say that this method gave us a quite good approximation of pi, even if we just use random points. Fantastic. From this experience, we've seen that for Monte Carlo algorithms, even if they use randomness, they can give results with a really small error. I hope that you understood this algorithm. If you want to support the channel, like and subscribe, and you can buy one of the algorithms related courses in the description. See you in the next one.